Hey everybody, I'm back. This is three updates in one day. Pretty sure that's a record for me. I've been doing a lot of work on the boat and catching up, making up for lost time. I got all the mahogany cut. I got the big mahogany board planed down. So if you recall from the last video, I was planing that. I planed it down to 5/8 rather than a half inch. Just seemed a little bit more substantial, and I don't know, it's not going to add that much weight. So I planed that down, got it cut up, and if you look down here, I have the glue up. So this is going to be the transom right here. It's two pieces, and Wonky was helping out the whole time, so he's super happy to be out here, freshly shaved. That's not weird at all, is it? What I did with this big board, so this was 144 inches long. I didn't want to cut it down and then plane it just because the snipe, going into and out of the planer would leave, some differing thicknesses at the ends of the board. So I ran the whole board through and, then cut it up after the fact. So, what I did is I planed it to thickness of 5/8 inch. Then I cut it to about 55 inches. The final length needs to be 54, for these two. And then the off cut here is the dash. So the dash, I'm going to do a lot of back and forth here. The dash is this board right here. So I think this is like 20 inches wide up here and then it necks down, So it's 20 inches wide at the top, next down at the bottom. So what I'm going to do right now, if Wonky will get out of the way, which he probably won't, is kind of go through my bill of materials. So this is my bill of materials here. And I'm gonna scoot over here, get out of the way of Wonky. So I'm just going to focus on that real quick for everyone. If you're building along, which you probably aren't, because I don't think anybody's making a boat like this. I don't think anybody really made any when the magazine came out. So there's probably not a lot of people making them now. But this is the bill of materials from the original article, with some additions and a couple of omissions. So this is the original bill of materials. Really, this just quantifies the lumber. So the mahogany, the oak, and the spruce. I haven't done anything with oak just because I have some oak lying around and I'm just kind of going to wing it with that. The mahogany and the spruce, I ordered those. I can get the mahogany locally, but not the spruce, oddly enough. So I got those at Chesapeake Light Craft along with the marine plywood, which is pretty difficult to find these days, actually. Excuse me. So what I'm going to do, pardon me, is just go through the cut list here and relate to everyone out there who might be following along, if you care, just what each of these components are and what the final cut looks like and any problems I might have had along the way. So it's just informational. So we'll start with, well, I'll start with an overview here. So this is all the lumber, minus number 7 and number 8, which is the keel and the transom and knee braces, which I'm just going to make out of maybe oak. I have, if you look up over there, I have a bunch of walnut, oak, and cherry, which, I don't know, I might end up using those. And that to me is what I've come to realize is that, hey, you can use whatever you want to make this boat. I've already started to deviate from the bill of materials that you see in front of you. So starting over here, this is going from 1 through 16. So 1A right here. Hey buddy, there's Wonky. He's here to help us. 1A is the bottom chine. It's two pieces, sorry. It's 1A and 1B. That's my own numbering system. I did all this on the table saw and it came out really good.
I was definitely worried about cutting such long boards. You know, they're 12 feet long, and my table saw is not that great. So I had a couple of infeed and outfeed rollers, which you see right here, and my table saw is just kind of bottom of the barrel construction site table saw. You know, a couple hundred bucks, and it's okay. You always have to check and recheck the fence. Always make sure that you know the infeed the width at the infeed side is less than the width at the outfeed side to prevent binding of the blade. Most of these cuts I did without any sort of guards or anything other than the riving knife. You always want to keep the riving knife on there. It's definitely, you know, put the guards on when you can, but with some of these big boards and with reconfiguring the cuts all the time, it's difficult to keep the safety devices on the saw all the time. So use good sense. Don't put your fingers into the blade or any other parts. So that's mostly what I did, and I did have to do some kind of resawing on this as well. There are a couple of boards. I think actually on this board here, if you look along the length, you see it came out really good. But I had to make this cut twice. Once with Wonky. There's Wonky again. He's always here, always helping. So once to cut out this area, and another cut out this area. So, you know, two passes on that, and you know, there's obviously nothing you can put on there safety wise to guard your fingers or to prevent kickback, other than making sure that everything's properly adjusted. So, back to what I was saying, we have 1A and 1B, which are the bottom chines, which took me a little while to figure out. I mean, it's clearly labeled here, but you have the bottom chine going along along here, which is really, it's this piece right here. So it doesn't have to be mahogany. It could easily be spruce, and I have a lot of offcuts that I've saved. So this is all my scrap from what I've cut so far. And a lot of this stuff could be useful if I screw something up. It's a little bit undersized. It's kind of odd dimensions, but it can do in a pinch. And you know, that's the thing to keep in mind with this build, is that you know, if it calls for a half inch wide stringer, if it's, you know, if it's less than that, that's fine. You just make a smaller notch in the frame to accommodate that, and it's not a big deal. So anyways, we have this what do we call it, bottom chine. So this is called the bottom chine. I labeled it with my system. This is 1A and 1B, so it's gonna be left and right. And the next, let's see, next on the list is the transom. So the transom is what I'm gluing up here, and I went over you know, how I cut that earlier today. And that's the first glue up, and what I'm using for glue is just Tight Bond 3 Ultimate Wood Glue, waterproof exterior, interior. I figure, you know, it should probably do the trick. Most of this stuff is going to be fiberglass anyways, so I'm not going to overthink the whole glue situation. Number 3 is the dash. This is the dash. I don't have it labeled. It, you know, it's kind of unique as far as all these go. I'm not going to forget what it is. And I'm actually thinking about doing some sort of laminate, maybe having like a walnut strip in the middle or something like that. We'll see, but you know, that's just another variation from the plans, which you know, aren't actually that great. So looking at number 4, deck beams. So this is the deck beams. So this is what it called for, is this 5-inch wide piece of mahogany that's, I think, a half inch thick. And like I said, I had to saw this width twice, because the table saw can only, you know, cut a depth of like 2.5 to 3 inches. So this is 5 inches wide. So I had to do, you know, cut this part, then cut this part, you know, running it through that direction. And came out pretty good. And again, this is, it's rough on this side. I'm okay with that. It'll take a little bit of sanding. I could run it through the planer, but that might take too much off of it. So I'm probably just gonna sand it in place. So those deck beams, and it's not clear from the instructions, but the deck beams, and it does call it out here. And if you're good at reading blueprints, which I'm not, the deck beams are these top pieces going across here. It's like this. There we go. So those are the deck beams, and those are mahogany. And it's kind of clear if you flip through the instructions. Again, there's a lot of this back and forth, cross-referencing things. So these are your deck beams right there. See, I even called them out. So that's deck beam. That's the dash right there. And this right here is a seat. You can see the darker mahogany there. It's not called out explicitly. But anyways, so those are number four, the deck beams. So that's going to have to get cut down some more because there's two different deck beams. So the cockpit combing, I misspelled it there, is number five. So that's, I have two pieces, 5A and 5B. Again, they're mahogany. One of them's rough on one side, and I think I cut them out of two very different sections of the boards just to try to preserve material. So the cockpit combing is again what runs along the inside of the cockpit and prevents spray from getting into the cockpit, which it's pretty short, and you can see it here just running along the inside there. You can see a darker portion, and that's the mahogany cockpit combing. So that's number five. And number six is the shear guard. So I got 6A and I got 6B sitting right here. And that's what runs along the outside. It's not installed here. And from the pictures, it's kind of visible right there. That's the shear guard. Right? Shear guard. Yep. So I'm still figuring out a lot of this terminology, figuring out what's what on the boat, because if you read through these directions, I don't think it calls out install a shear guard or anything like that. It just kind of assumes that you're going to. There's a lot of things that are assumed. It takes a lot of time to figure out. So the keel is oak, as are the transom and knee braces. I haven't done anything with them. I may do the keel out of oak. It's going to have to be glued up. I can get that locally, no problem. I may do it out of walnut, but the keel is really the bottom batten. So there's spruce battens on either side, and I'm going to have to do a little bit more legwork on that. But it can be oak, it can be something else, we'll see. I haven't done anything with that, but not super worried there. So, moving on. We have the keel, transom and knee braces. Actually, I'm not gonna gloss over the transom and knee braces because that refers to these pieces back here. They're kind of gussets that the author says should be bolted through. Actually, not 100% sure, but that's what it's referring to. I have to do a little bit more research on exactly how those are configured, but that's what it's referring to on number eight. So number nine is the shears and chines. Let's go over here. There we go. So we got number 9A, 9B, 9C, and 9D right here. So these are all spruce. So everything after this is going to be spruce. I already cut that up actually a long time ago. And so that is referring to these pieces that run along the inside. and run through the frames. So on the outside. So it's right here, here and here, if you will. Pardon the extreme close up of my hand. So the shears and chines are kind of like stringers that run along the side, I think. I'm doing my best to use the terminology correctly, but forgive me if I misspeak because, it's new to me. And anyway, so the shears and chines are cut, good to go. The side frames are, so the frames are the pieces that run across the boat. So you have the transom, which is really like the rear frame. And then going from the front, from the bow, you have frame one, frame two, frame three. So the side pieces of the frames, which are these pieces right here, are spruce, and those have been cut. Those are, what did I say? Number 10. So that's number 10 right there. So this is going to be the side frames, right here. And then we have 11. I have 11A. There is no 11B. And that's the bottom of frame number 3. So that's exactly what you think it is. That's the bottom of the frame. And then you have the battens. I called them battens A and battens B. In truth, they're not labeled that way in the instructions. I just delineated them that way. But essentially, so you have battens A. You need two of them, and they're 96 inches long. Battens B are 60 inches long. I haven't cut them down to length yet, so the thickness and the width is the same on each of them. It's just that one's shorter than the other. And those are these pieces right here. And so that's keel, batten. You can't see it back here. It's this piece right there. Batten. And I drew a little diagram for myself somewhere. Here we go. So this kind of reminds me of what the difference between a batten and a stringer and the keel is. So keel runs along the center of the boat. The stringers run perpendicular to the keel and the battens. And the battens are beside the keel and, again, perpendicular to the stringers. So that's not explicitly stated. That is common parlance in the boat building world. This is the first boat I built, so very new to me. But and then you have the bottom stringers, A and B, which again, the difference is that A stringers are 96 inches long, B stringers are 60 inches long. So you have three of the A stringers and two of the B stringers. So what you end up with is long stringer, keel, really long stringer on either side. Short stringer, and again, long batten. It's not shown here. Short batten, and then you have the chine, and the shear as well. And so that covers everything that's been cut, except for the one thing that I missed in the bill of materials, and that was my mistake. There are lots of mistakes in the bill of materials as well as just in the instructions. Not lots, but there's a few, and it definitely tripped me up. But I had stated in an earlier video, I had missed the bottom of, I think it's this is the bottom of frame number 3. I just got a piece of pine, and I'm going to make it out of that. So that really covers... that's the bottom of frames 1 and 2. So bottom of frame number 3, I have that. It's number 11. It's made out of spruce. The bottom frame, so that's going to be frames 1 and 2, are going to be pine, and I'm good with that. Not the end of the world. It looks a lot like the spruce, so not the end of the world there at all. It's just a little bit denser, and you know, that's okay. So what you see here is pretty much all of the solid lumber that's going to be used for the boat, with the exception of the oak to make the keel and the transom and knee braces. So my next step after this, I know that was a long video, but this was a lot of work to just figure out what all the terms meant, what cuts need to be made, what cuts need to be made in order to ensure that I had enough material for everything. So that was a lot of work too. If I had purchased extra mahogany, extra spruce, it would have been a lot easier. It would have been a little bit more expensive. To me, that expense is worth it. So just, if you're going into this, get an extra board of mahogany, get an extra board, 12 foot long by, you know, by 1 inch by 6 inch wide piece of mahogany. And the same for the spruce. You'll be able to, you won't have to be so conservative with your cuts. With my cuts, I had to make sure that I was using every little bit of the material that I could. If you look here at the scraps that I have, you know, it's really, this is the biggest piece of scrap that I have, this scrap piece of spruce. There's a couple that are a little bit more substantial, but you can see most of the offcuts are really thin. It would have been good to be able to plane it and joint it, joint the boards, but they're almost too big that you kind of can't do that. And you, I was very fortunate. I got my lumber from Chesapeake Light Craft, in Annapolis, and it was very square when I got it. Yeah, it's rough cut, but, you know, again, it just has to be boat shaped when you're done with it. So if it, if there's a little bit of sanding that needs to be done to get things down to size, or if you have to plane it, and it's a little bit undersized after you have it cut, that's fine. So I know this was a long video, kind of boring unless you're actually trying to make this boat, which, I'd be surprised if anyone's making boats like this. If you are, let me know. I'm not an expert, but I'm figuring things out. So hope that helps. Bye.